Hey there, Josh here, developer advocate from Zeplin, and today I'm going to answer a question we've heard a lot lately from developers, designers, and PMs about Figma's introduction of Dev Mode, and that's, doesn't Dev Mode basically do the same thing that Zeplin does? Well, come here. Whoa, too close. So Dev Mode and Zeplin differ in a few specific ways, and the teams who are going to feel it the most are those with more than a handful of developers, or if you have a product with complex user flows or complex technical requirements, maybe if you have multiple levels of approval, several stakeholders due to your industry or organization. You know, if your team builds products at a smaller scale, you'll likely find that Figma Dev Mode is good enough. But here's four ways where good enough turns messy and confusing for mature teams. So let's start with design readiness. How do your designers share which designs are ready to build for developers? And do they all use the same methods? Are the designs that are ready separated from the designs that are still being worked on? With Dev Mode, developers can mark frames, components, or sections as ready for dev. And that seems straightforward enough and likely just fine for smaller dev teams. But what happens when you need to make changes to a section or frame that's marked ready for dev? For example, what if your PM gives feedback that needs to be addressed right away? Or what if your designer is struck with a brilliant idea in the middle of the night? And when you've got a larger team relying on these ready for dev sections in Figma, developers could build off the wrong designs if it's not actually ready or they're not referencing the latest versions, leading to more rework later on. Zeplin, on the other hand, is a separate space to document and share locked designs with developers. These locked designs do not coexist with the rest of the in-progress designs in a wide open, confusing canvas or multiple pages. Simply publish screens from Figma to Zeplin, and your team knows exactly what to build and where to find it. In Zeplin, you can even filter screens by status, assignee, or Jira ticket, or just run a search in your workspace. This means that as a developer, I have multiple ways to navigate designs and pinpoint to the exact thing I need. Sure, there's some workarounds in Figma where designers can group designs into pages based on status or other organization hacks, and it really depends on the designer to put in that extra effort to build out that standardized organization method. And it's quite reminiscent of the old days, which is the reason why Zeplin was built in the first place, to clean up for all that mess. The next major difference between Dev Mode and Zeplin is how versioning works. When I open up the compare changes view in Dev Mode, I'll see a list of autosave versions of the file. And I'm sure that for designers, autosave is a really useful feature. But as a developer, what I really want to compare is the difference between this version and the last version that was sent to me. So now I have to go down this list here and try to find out where I actually have changes to take action on. It's also common for designers handling versions in Figma to duplicate a frame and make changes in that duplicate version so it won't overwrite what's in the current version. Now, the problem with this common workflow is that it wipes out the entire version history for the frame, leaving you with no original file to use as a comparison. Now, versioning with Zeplin is totally different. Zeplin captures and tracks versions at the screen level, so every screen has its own version history. And since all designs in Zeplin are locked, the overall versioning is similar to a Git push, which every developer is familiar with. And now to actually compare the differences between the screens, you can select the checkbox here to highlight any change layers between the selected version and the previous one, so you'll never even miss just a few pixels changing. And you'll notice this handy change indicator here, which tallies up the number of layers added, changed, or removed on each new screen version. This level of version control also works for components. Like before, I can show the differences between versions by enabling this checkbox here. It looks like the border radius changed slightly, and I can see that as I hover over this yellow highlighted text that shows the previous value was 8 points. And when I move the version history out of the way here, I'll get a deeper look at that component's variants and states. Another major difference between Dev Mode and Zeplin is how they bring cross-functional team members together to collaborate on final designs. It's pretty typical for product managers, marketing, legal, and potentially a bunch of other folks to collaborate on designs. If you just need their involvement during the design phase, Figma works great, but once designs move into later stages of product development, collaboration in Figma gets harder to manage, even with Dev Mode. A designer in Figma needs to prep their files by organizing designs into developer-specific pages, which could be different than how they'd want to organize pages within their design team, or give developers a canvas full of scattered text boxes to annotate any dev requirements they may need to know about in the design. If your team consists of just a few people, again, this isn't a big deal, but just think of how complicated that gets with a large team or a complex app. Like, imagine someone from your legal team probing through your file to find a group of screens to make sure they're in compliance. In comparison, Zeplin is made to help teams collaborate between design and development in a structured way. So for example, in Zeplin, you can sort by custom tags or Jira issue. You can track a screen's progress with status tags and assign to someone for the next steps, request approvals, and easily flag what's pending so you don't waste time on unapproved work. And that's just a sample of how Zeplin improves workflow management by giving your team much more of the structure and organization they need to collaborate on designs. And that's really going to matter if you've got a lot of developers, a lot of designs, a complex product, or designers and devs working across multiple projects. Now, the last difference I'll cover here is user journeys. Figma gives designers a sandbox that allows for flexibility in showing user journeys, and maybe that's a little bit too much flexibility, which makes things hard to follow. Zeplin, on the other hand, has a dedicated user journey feature called Flows, which allows you to quickly build out every path and conditional flow using actual design screens. And as you can see, it's easy to snap screens into place and use templates to fill out spots where your high fidelity mockups aren't ready yet. And what's nice is that Flows will automatically update when you've published a new screen, and you can just click into that screen to view the specs you need. So, are Dev Mode and Zeplin similar? So as I mentioned at the beginning, smaller dev teams can probably get by with Dev Mode. But for any team with more than a handful of developers or teams operating with more complex product or organization, using Dev Mode comes with too many little hidden quirks that can put the build at risk. So you probably already know from experience, trying to do design, development, and PM work in one canvas really hinders your ability to have clear design requirements delivered. But adding Zeplin into your workflow, you get a lot of key features to build more efficiently. That includes clarity on what to build and version management that actually is usable, control of approvals and workflow tracking, a consistent and intuitive interface that's easy to navigate, and a bonus of harmony across the happy team because everyone has an equal space and way to collaborate on ready-to-build designs. If you want to learn more, Zeplin's free to try. Check it out at zeplin.io, and you can also install the Zeplin plugin for Figma right away too. If you have any questions, head over to our community Discord server that I'll link down in the description, and that's where you'll find me and other Zeplin crew members. I'll see you there.